Today is a very special day, June 9th. Black Ops 6 being revealed. Probably already has by the time you watch this video. It's my birthday, and I can finally share with you that I've played Black Ops 6. That's right. Shout out to Call of Duty and Treyarch for flying me out to LA to the Treyarch Studios to witness this year's Call of Duty. So I need you guys to sit back. I need you to get comfortable because I'm going to go over absolutely everything that I'm allowed to right now.
Okay, everyone, lock in and be ready. I need you to be here for this entire video because we're going to cover absolutely everything that I saw at Treyarch's studios. We're going to talk about campaign. We're going to talk about multiplayer. We're going to talk about zombies. We're going to talk about the omnidirectional movement that you're seeing leaked all over the place. I'm going to cover absolutely everything for you guys, and everything that I talk about is 100% confirmed. That's right, Team Chaos is officially back. The new Treyarch studio was amazing. If you want to see some behind the scenes inside looks of the studio, make sure you guys are following me on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok. Now, there is a lot of things that you're probably seeing in the Black Ops 6 Direct that will confirm for you, but I have stuff that's not even in the Black Ops 6 Direct. So keep that in mind. I did play Black Ops 6 multiplayer, but that's all I can say about that experience for now. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to talk about multiplayer stuff that was confirmed to us that they told us we could actually talk about. So I'm going to go through all my notes. I'm going to go through all the facts, and I'm going to try to keep it in some order for you guys. But if you have questions, feel free to hit me up in the comments. I will answer every one of them that I can. And at the end of this video, I'm going to give you my honest assessment of Black Ops 6, having played it, having seen it, having been to most of the Black Ops early reveals and alphas and betas in my history, I'm going to give you guys my real opinion. So we'll start off with the release date, October 25th. And we actually have a timeline. They confirmed the timeline for us, and I'm going to bounce back and forth between my own notes and the stuff they gave me, because my own notes actually have a little more involved here. And I forgot to ask, do me a favor, drop a like on this video. Make sure you guys are subscribed. I told you 2 or 3 months ago that we were back 100%, and we are. Call of Duty, FPS games, anything big in the gaming world, we're covering it. So the timeline, the official timeline for Black Ops 6, we have the original Black Ops. So if you're looking at a timeline, hopefully it's on the screen right now. First is Black Ops. We could put World at War on there, but they didn't do it. Then we have Cold War. Then we have Black Ops 2, the flashback 1989 missions. Nothing about the future missions, but I have a feeling we're going to learn something about that in the future. But the Black Ops 2 1989 missions are now canon in the Black Ops universe, in the continuity. Then we have Black Ops 6. That's where we're going to be at right now. It's going to be set in 1991, and then we have Black Ops 4, and we ended off with Black Ops 3. So that is your official timeline for the canon Black Ops universe right now. So the campaign, let's talk about it. Bombastic, dynamic, everything you could think about, and more. It's going to be this moment-to-moment gameplay, and the big thing I took away from what the developers said is they did everything with intention. What they mean by that is they broke down and stripped down everything from past Black Ops, and everything they picked and did from the campaign to the multiplayer to zombies, they did it with intention. They didn't just do it to do it or to be flashy. Everything had a reason. So you're going to get those blockbuster set pieces. You're going to get those action-packed moments, all that stuff. You're going to get cloak and dagger spy activity, and it looks really, really good. So keep that in mind as we go on. Let me set it up for you. It sets up after the events of Black Ops Cold War, and it ties into those 1980s flashbacks from Black Ops 2, which I said, it takes place in the early 90s, specifically around 1991, and it's during that period of transition when just global politics and everything is being characterized by the end of the Cold War. And we are knee-deep in the Gulf War. So yes, Black Ops 6 is Gulf War. And you're going to be able to do the spy, thriller, single-player narrative, but you're also going to be able to go in hot if you want to, government conspiracy, all that stuff that Black Ops is known for, you're going to love it. Plus some huge twists and turns. We're going to go to the Russian tundra. We're going to go to the Middle Eastern desert. We're going to go to Southern Europe. We're going to go to the United States. We're going to go into a mission where Bill Clinton is governor and he's wanting to run for president. It's crazy. Crazy, crazy stuff. Frank Woods is back. Russell Adler is back. We're going to get new allies, Troy Marshall, Jane Harrow. Marshall is actually going to be the main protagonist of this entire game. And then we're going to get all kinds of cool 90s equipment, gadgets, things like that. They are upgrading the safe house. So it's an abandoned manor and a KGB black site, and they are going to make it even more in-depth. If you are a lore hound and you want to know the history of everything going on, you're going to be able to do that in between selecting your missions. The campaign looks solid, and I asked the question to them directly, how long is the campaign? And they said, we'll be happy. They said it fits right in line with past Black Ops campaigns that people were happy with. So to me, I think we're going to get a good, solid campaign. I don't think it's going to be a 2 or 3 hour cutscene campaign, and then it's gone. They did talk about the big bad, and it's actually not the government. It's kind of within the government, and it is a group called the Pantheon. And we have to kind of go rogue. We don't have to kind of. We have to go rogue. So we have to detach from everybody, go rogue, try to figure out who has infiltrated the government, and figure out how to take down the Pantheon. Think Captain America when he's trying to take down Hydra. Hydra has infiltrated the government over the years, and that's kind of the same vibe that I get. Now, let's jump straight into multiplayer because I know that's what everybody wants to talk about. Look, somebody posted a leak about Omni Movement, and they put up references to games that do not correlate with what Omni Movement is. Okay? It is a redefined movement, and it's across all game modes. It's going to allow the player to move realistically and seamlessly through chain movements. I mean, that's exactly what it is. That's exactly how it worked, and that's exactly what it looked like. So let me give you some examples. Players can sprint, slide, dive in any direction. Plus, if you're prone, you can now supine prone. So in the past, if you're prone and you're sitting on your belly button, you kind of crawl and spin around in a circle, right? You don't do that anymore. You actually rotate while you're prone. That's right. So you roll onto your side if you want to go one way, or roll onto the other side. It is as fluid and realistic as I've ever seen in a Call of Duty game. You're going to have so much more freedom for movement, so much more freedom for tactical flexibility. Yes, you can actually dive backwards on your back, guns up, through a window while you're still shooting. Did I mention to you guys you can pick people up and use them as meat shields? I don't know if I did. I don't think we're supposed to call it that. But yeah, you can pick up somebody and use them as a meat shield. So keep that in mind as well. But I want to stress the Omni movement. Do you remember old-fashioned strafing? Well, it's not like that anymore. It's actually realistic. You run to the side and you can jump backwards, jump sideways, jump forward, literally all of it. And it's seamless. Not only that, but they also put intelligent movement and corner slicing capabilities in the game. If you don't know what corner slicing is, they're slicing the pie. Think of the SWAT teams when they go around the corners and they're kind of at that 45 degree angle and they're slicing the pie as they go through. It's all intuitive now. It does it for you. And I can't speak on multiplayer. It looks great. Let me just give you a thumbs up through the video screen and just there. I'm just going to, yeah, it looks great. Okay, so keep that in mind. Another big one I don't know if they're going to touch on much was intelligent movement. So let me lay it out for you. Sprint assist, mantle assist, crouch assist. All those in the past, you had to hit a button. So let's say in an action, you're down on the bottom of a ravine and you're trying to climb up a wall and then sprint up and do certain actions to get where you want to go. You would hit the button 4 to 5 times. You hit the button 0 times now. It's all intuitive. It's all intelligent. The sprint assist, the mantle assist, the crouch, it's reactive to the environment, which means you get to stay on target. You don't have to use those extra button pushes. It was smooth. It was so, so smooth. I don't want to act like I'm over here just drinking the Kool-Aid crazy, crazy, crazy. So I'm trying to keep it grounded. But from what I saw and what I experienced, these integrations, they very well could change how the games are made moving forward. I'm going to say that's how I honestly feel. Let's talk about maps. Everybody and their mother, including me, was worried about getting a couple new maps and then getting a bunch of remastered maps. That's the topic of conversation always. Oh, we don't want remastered maps. We want brand new experiences. We definitely want brand new Treyarch three-lane experiences, right? Well, they checked off the box. 16 brand new maps at launch. That's 12 core 6v6 maps and 4 strike maps that can be played as 2v2, 6v6, 1v1, whatever you want. And I did talk to one of the leads at Treyarch, and they said, yes, you're going to get that vibe of classic three-lane Treyarch frantic maps. So you can get excited about that. The other thing, the biggest box we're probably going to check off today, is classic prestige. It's going to be there day one. It's not going to be one of those things, oh, we'll bring it to you in season one. It will be there on launch day. And man, so if you don't know what classic prestige is, think back to the early days of Call of Duty, where you would level up to level 55, and then you would reset, and you would lose all your stuff. You would go back down, and you would do this 10 times. That's exactly what we've got here, 10 prestiges. But once you get through the 10 prestiges, then you are actually going to go into Master Prestige, which is 1,000 prestiges. You heard me right, 1,000 prestiges. Now, we asked them some hard questions about how the classic prestige is going to work. Is it going to be super, super rewarding, or is it going to be super, super hard on you like the early prestiges for when they wiped out everything? They said they took every classic prestige mode. They broke them down. They took the best aspects of each one, and then they moved forward. They couldn't give us details on rewards or things like that, but they said this is the best version of classic prestige that they've ever had. And once you get to max level and you go through the 1,000 prestige levels there, there's supposed to be something redacted that is just absolutely insane. So that core progression loop is back. Level 1 through 55, unlock your weapons and gear, reset, get your prestige medals, tokens, and move forward. I know a lot of you are going to be happy with that. I hope you are. I mean, I really, really do. No level cap, no seasonal level cap. That stuff is gone, and it's available on day one. Okay, let's stick with multiplayer, and let's check off a third major box, which you already saw leaked, and I'm here to confirm it. Theater mode returns for players, for everybody, every angle. Theater mode is back, baby. But not only that, they also have new options for HUD presets. And they showed us the HUD and the UI and everything like that, and they simplified it. They dummied it down to make it cleaner and way easier and compact to use. But here's the cool one. This is brand new. The ability to move the minimap and remove the HUD elements on your interface. They're widgets. You can take your mini map. You can make it circle, square. If you don't like it in the top left, you can move it to the bottom right. You can move it to the center right. Heck, I think you could probably even put it in the center of the screen. Your weapon icons, you can move them anywhere you want. You can take each widget and customize your HUD however you want. They said they're going to expand upon that in the future, but that's a first for Call of Duty as well. They also said when it comes to multiplayer that we will be getting 12 guns that have never been seen in Call of Duty. That's huge. 12 guns we've never seen. And I've got some more notes here that I put out. Of course, score streaks are back. Wild cards are back. You've got tactical. You've got lethal. You've got field upgrades. You have enforcer perks, recon perks, strategist perks, 5 default classes, 10 custom classes, 1 dedicated quick equip. And then for attachments, you have 5 attachment slots. And then if you use a wild card, you have 8. There's a primary, a secondary, melee. You can have detailed weapon stats. Yes, gunsmith is back. Shared optics are back. Mastery badges, dedicated melee, combat specialties. The shooting range is back. And I already told you guys, the theater mode is back. No, we are not getting the pick 10 system this year. But with all of this, it looks like it's going to be pretty solid. Also, back on the maps, they said they designed these with competitive in mind. So there you go. That is multiplayer in a nutshell. I lied. I've got more. I just saw in my notes. I want to talk really quick about visual fidelity. This is the absolute best Call of Duty game you've ever seen when it comes to graphics. That's it. I mean, from the dirt under their fingernails to the sweat to the blood, everything, the pores on their face, their hands, their hair, everything is dynamic. This thing is going to look absolutely crazy. But I actually got some weapon names, and they showed them in the presentation, so I asked 3 times. They said, I can talk about anything I took notes for in there. the Ames 85, the Jackal AK-74U, the XM4 rifle, the Marine SP pump shotgun, a compact 92 9mm, an SVD sniper rifle, and a 9mm PM. Now, I'm just going to leave it at that, but I wanted to make sure that you guys got to see that. I also forgot. I said multiplayer's done. It's not done. They showed us so much. You can dive into water, like headfirst dive with your hands out. Like, you can actually dive. You can dive in Call of Duty. Not dolphin dive. You can actually dive. On the animation hit points, when you die or get shot, it used to be 4 locations on your body grid. Now, it's 9. Which opens it up for hundreds of thousands of death animations and ragdolls as you go. They also upgraded the death cam. It's now a dynamic death cam, and it's going to track your body movement after you die. The podium is back. The top 3 is back. And there is a best play of the game or best player of the game camera thing at the end as well. It is not the final play of the game. It is whatever the algorithm or AI chooses was the best play of the game. Those are all returning. And now let's talk about zombies. Black Ops 6 will mark the return of round-based zombies. I know everybody wants that. You've already seen the leaks. There are 2 brand new maps at launch, Liberty Falls and Terminus. And they feature a curated mix of weapons, upgrades, enemies, all that good stuff. Terminus looks like a massive, massive map. I mean, Treyarch zombies, they're going big. And what they told us about these 2 maps is they are both going at the same time. So they are happening at the same time. So keep that in mind as you go. And the 4 main people in it is Grigori Weaver, Elizabeth Gray, Matt Carver, and Maya Aguinaldo. It's a new one, but you can also play as other operators. But if you want the full experience, you need to play as those 4. And yes, we are going to continue where Dr. Peck charges a boat to visit old friends 5 years later. It is literally picking right up in 1991, from the past. I mean, that's it. I know zombies players are going to be super, super excited. So get ready for zombies. It's going to be something. They also wanted us to make sure and make you guys aware that there is no name for the new engine. It is the shared engine that is shared across all Call of Duty studios, and they want to keep it that way. It's the shared engine that they use, and it is to bring continuity and just a balance and a kind of familiarity, I guess you could say, with all the Call of Duty games moving forward. Now, I've got some stuff I want to talk about that you may not be super happy with, but I want to say it anyway. Content in Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3 will not carry over to Black Ops 6, but your Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3 and Black Ops 6 content will be in Warzone. So that's kind of okay. Oh, that sucks. But then that's okay. They also talked about the season 1 launcher updates, the new COD HQ, the new improved experience. They're going for an overall smaller footprint with that, which I think is a great thing. So let's recap everything we've talked about. And you know what? I missed some multiplayer stuff. This is what happens when you stick around till the end of the video. You get the good stuff. Equipment. I can confirm. The RC car is back. A controllable knife. This one's a little, I don't know. You throw a knife and then you can aim it through the air, but I'm not going to go into that one. A grenade you can attach to an enemy, walk up to them, kick them into somebody else, and they blow up. The stim shot is back. A spring mine, which is 4 claymores zip tied together. Yeah, I'll let you guys give your comments on that one. Warcry batons, which actually are an area effect thing. So if you use the Warcry baton flares, you walk up and it's going to buff your teammates, which is kind of wild. Signal lure, broadcast your position to every enemy. Let me talk about that. So you can set off a signal lure, and it will tell every enemy on the map where you're at. They can find you, easy. And then as you kill them, you get extra bonuses for it. So if you just want to go rogue and be that guy, you can do that. That's going to be interesting. Spy camera with the gun up, which is cool. Takes pics of enemies, which tags them for your team. Think of a recon drone, but as a spy camera on your gun. And yeah, other little movement things I didn't talk about. Like now, if you go through a door and you have momentum, you just shoulder a bust through the door. It's all intuitive and it's all instinctive in the engine now. The movement, you're going to be able to do so much more movement with so much less with your hands, is what they've been going for. And from what I experienced, they knocked it out of the park. So now, let's recap. Classic Prestige back. Classic Zombies mode back. 16 brand new maps at launch. 12 brand new guns never seen in the Call of Duty universe at launch. A campaign that is looking like it's going to be something absolutely wild. A confirmed timeline for the Black Ops universe. Omni movement for the first time. And so many intuitive and just upgrades to how you move. Intelligent movement on a whole new level. This is all that you can expect from Black Ops 6. I told you guys a couple months ago. I've had people ask me, why are you back? Why are you doing this? You took like 4 years off from Call of Duty. And I did for multiple reasons. One was burnout. Two, I was not happy with the direction that Call of Duty was going. But as soon as I kind of confirmed how long Treyarch's, the team over there, has had to work on this game, and I knew what it was, I knew that this was probably the best chance to jump back in and be part of something special that would kind of bring me back as a Call of Duty fan. So that's where we're at. One more time, huge thank you to the team at Treyarch, to all the familiar faces that I got to see in LA at the new Treyarch studios. It was great. There was a lot of new faces that I didn't recognize either, and that's just kind of the changing of the guard. I'm the old guy now, which is fine. I accept that, but it was a ton of fun. So thank you to all of them. Thank you to all of you that stuck around for this entire video and watched everything and just soaked it all up. Make sure you're subscribed. Make sure you stay on point with the channel and the Facebook and the Instagram and the Twitter and the TikTok, because we're covering everything. And there's a lot of other stuff out there that isn't just Call of Duty that's exciting too. I just kind of saw the Gears of War Remastered leaks. That's wild. A new Doom game. That's wild. It's going to be a good year for gaming fans. But focusing on Call of Duty, it's going to be a great year for Team Chaos. I hope you guys have a great day. Leave your questions below, and I'll see you soon.